Hey, I'm Yao from Interactive Engineers team. Today, I'm going to show you how to use speech recognition in LenStudio. We will go through all the main features for speech recognition. An example, I'm going to show you how to use speech recognition to make a video greeting card. The winter season is coming. We all miss the days when we can go visit our family members or go shop some winter accessories together. With speech recognition, we will transcribe our voice to a greeting card and trigger different visual effects with specific words to make the greeting card alive. Now let's take a look at the project together. We have some pre-made winter accessories. The first one is a hat, second one is a snowflake sunglasses, and the last one is a fluffy headset. We also have a winter theme image here. We can use it as our greeting card. Now let's get started with the speech recognition. Let's go to the asset library and find the asset called System Voice Command. This asset has all the latest features for speech recognition. Import that into our project and drag the asset under the orthographic camera. We can see an info card pop up in the preview panel. With this info card, we can get some basic information for this asset. We now can say take a snap, start recording, or stop recording in Snapchat without pressing any button. Now let's delete this info card for now and click the root of the asset. Here we can see a speech recognition script. This is the main helper script for speech recognition. This script is using VoiceML module for speech recognition and also the audio from microphone component for voice input. In the preview panel, if we click on the microphone button, we can then enable the voice input. As I speaking, you can already see the transcription in the preview panel. Let's disable this function for now. We will go through the five main features for speech recognition. These terms might be confusing to you if this is your first time to use speech recognition, but don't worry, we will go through them one by one. The first one is transcription. We have two different choices for transcription type. The first one is transcription. With transcription, we can only get the transcription back when we finish the full sentences. And the other one is live transcription. With live transcription, we can get transcription back when we finish the word. This is a common use in a lot of the media player. For instance, in the movie, we can get closed caption, and the closed caption sometimes can be get a mandate on the fly. Now let's test this live transcription. As you can see, we can see a much quicker response in the preview panel. Cool. However, for this project, our goal is to write a greeting card. Instead of replacing the screen text here, we are going to add the new transcription to the previous one. So we need to change the transcription tab to transcription and make some modifications in the speech recognition script. Let's open the speech recognition script with script editor. We need to find a function called UnUpdate Listening Event Handler. This is the callback function from VoiceML module. We'll get all the response back with this function. Now let's find where we set the final transcription to the screen text. Here, instead of replacing the text, we're going to add to the previous one. However, we do need to add a separator between the sentences. We also need to decide whether this is the start of the greeting card. If it's the start of the greeting card, we don't have to add the separators anymore. So here we are going to add a simple conditional operator. If the text is empty, then we will use the new transcription. Otherwise, we will add the separators here. Let's save the script and test again. Hello. It is snowing here. Cool. Now we can use our voice to write the greeting card. Now let's make some modification for the transcription test so it can fit to our greeting card. For the vertical alignment, we are going to use the top and horizontal one use the left. We can put some test text here so we can see it. We can also use a new font for this text so it feels more like a handwriting. And we will change the color to black. Get rid of the outline. Now it's looking much better. Cool. Let's jump to the next feature for speech recognition, speech context. As we all know, English words has a lot of similar pronunciation. Even though VoiceML module is trying to get the correct word with the context, but still it just cannot cover all the use case. With this powerful feature here, we can actually boosting some words for the specific lens. Here, for example, for this lens, we can add the phrase for snow or accessories. For the boost value, we recommend to start with 5. The higher the value, the more we boost the word. However, here we don't need to put all the words we are going to use in this lens here. It's more like a test thing. If we trying to transcribe some words and it doesn't really work well, then we can try to boost it here. Now let's move to the next feature, keyword. So this is a fun feature we have. With this enabled, we can then define any keyword based on the transcription. We also need to assign a keyword parent here. Under the keyword parent, we can already see a keyword here, snap. Let's say we try to make a snow effect when I say it is snowing here. So with the keyword script, we can define the keyword snow. We can also put a bunch of alias for the snow. For example, snowing or snowy. Or even snowflake. When I say any of the words, that this keyword will be then triggered. To have the snow VFX effect, let's download it from the asset library. Let's import the snow VFX effect and drag it into the objects panel. Now we can see we already have a snow VFX effect in the preview panel. Let's disable the snow ground because we don't really need that part. And let's disable this for now because we also want to trigger this effect with the speech keyword detection. So here it's actually pretty easy to trigger a new effect. If we enable the send triggers field here, we can then attach a bunch of behavior script to the field. Let's create a new behavior script here. For the trigger, we are going to set it to none because we will trigger that through the keyword script. And for the response type, we are going to choose set enabled. We're going to enable the snow effect with the behavior script. We also need to add the reference to the keyword script. Cool. Let's test this. Dear Granny, it is snowing here. Cool. Now we have the snow effect with the keyword snowing. What if we want to do the similar thing for the winter accessories? We can simply click on the keyword here and press Command and D to add a new keyword. We're gonna modify this keyword to accessories. We'll put accessories as a keyword and also accessories here for the alias. So instead of trigger the snow VFX object here, we are going to trigger the winter accessories object. Now let's test it again. Dear Granny, it is snowing here. I'm going to get some new winter accessories. Cool, that is working. Let's see what else we can do. Let's see, we have two color options for the hat, white and red. We can add a new keyword here, red. Put the same thing for the alias. And for the behavior script, instead of enable or disable an object, we can also change the color for the hair, the hat. Let's drag the material here and also put the hat visual here. We're going to change color to red. Cool, let's test again. Dear Granny, it is snowing here. I'm going to get some new winter accessories. There are two options for the hat color. One is white, the other one is red. Cool. Now all the effects is working. Let's move on to the next feature. Use command. With use command enabled, we can actually map what we're saying to a command list. We can find the command list in the speech recognition script. Here is the list. Since we cannot really define our own commands, the good thing about commands is that we don't have to say the exact words as the keyword. We can say go back, previous, or rewind for this command. With command triggered, the command handler functions will be also triggered when the command is detected. So here are all the functions here. We can write our own custom code for this, for the trigger effects. Let's move to the next one, system voice command. With system voice command, we can then say take snap, start recording, or stop recording. Once we push this to the device, it will just work in your lens. The last one is edit behaviors. With this field enabled, we can use VoiceML to trigger different behavior script. To learn more about this, you can find it in the speech recognition template or voice UI template. That's it for the speech recognition. Are you excited about the speech recognition feature in Lens Studio? Try to play with this new modality and create your own voice lens.